the vanishing point of the 3D illusion. When looking at row of buildings, for example, even if the buildings are all the same shape and size, the one at the end of the row will appear much smaller than the one closest to you. This vanishing point creates a triangular-shaped trajectory. This is evidence that the 3D world we see is the product of the Luciferian egregore mindset. The triangle pyramid is the most sacred and important symbol associated with the illusory God concept. This symbol is subliminally implanted within us without question, with everything we see. So how does this triangle trajectory occur? This can be explained by considering that the vanishing point is the place of origin. This original point of initiation is where thoughts conjure up the three-dimensional realm. This vanishing point is illusory. Whatever perspective the viewer has, if that perspective changes, the vanishing point changes. Proving again, that what we see is not really there, as the perspective moves according to the characteristics of a beam of light. What causes the three-dimensional realm to appear is time and space. But what causes time and space to appear real and valid? As with everything in the three-dimensional plane, the number and language system which has been created by the Luciferian group mind, appoints validity to time and space. Numbers and language are the very tool, the root source, of all subliminal messaging. Numbers and language are the thought process becoming intellectualized, creating the mathematical and geometric tools and systems that conjure up the three-dimensional illusory reality. Without numbers to measure the distance, there would be no physical distance. Without language to voice those numbers, there would be no way to communicate the existence of this distance. Therefore, the subliminal suggestion of its reality would not exist, and we would remain connected to our original wisdom state with no 3D reality interfering with our ability to remain focused on this eternal state. This is how we refocus, and reclaim, the power and freedom of the eternal state. Emotionally disconnecting from any belief in the 3D illusion as being real, reconnects who and what we really are, to the ultimate state of being. The chart below illustrates the vanishing point existing in everything illusory. Another significant event, fabricated by the Luciferian mindset just 2,000 illusory years ago, was the supposed first coming of the Messiah to save the world, the Jesus myth. Christianity was developed as the religion from this first coming and would move forward to manipulate reality to what we appear to be witnessing today. In reality, the illusory Jesus myth was nothing more than a subliminal suggesting that the Messiah will come, not has come, and will come again. The same sort of mind manipulation occurs in respect to the flood of Noah. The flood of Noah was just the suggestion, and the illusory evidence of a global deluge has been built into this illusory three-dimensional plane to establish belief in the flood event, and therefore, the ability to firmly believe it will happen again makes it able to happen again, even though it never occurred in the first place. Biblically speaking, as in the days of Noah, so shall the days of the coming of the Son of Man, Solomon, or sun and moon, be. They were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, Mary the moon flood goddess, and knew not until the flood came and took them all away. In other words, the flood never occurred as we're led to believe, and the first coming of Christ, the Messiah, never occurred. For this reason, it was simply suggested within the trance state, then recorded many elusive centuries later as having happened, and then, at the appointed illusory time, such as right now, certain events will occur, which brings this subliminal suggestion to the conscious level, and thereby establishes our illusory reality where a flood and a Messiah will manifest in many different ways. The flood and the Messiah are actually one and the same thing. This is the coming of the Son of Man, which is more accurately stated as the sun and moon. The sun is a subliminal for the sun savior. The moon is a subliminal for the moon goddess, the mother flood goddess, or Mary, the sea, the living water, that is suggested to save us. The three-dimensional illusory plan appears with its vanishing point. A breakdown of this word dimensional suggests death. Di equals die. Men equals humanity. Sign equals sun equals sun the Messiah. Al equals all equals LLA in reverse equals Allah equals the illusory Father God. Or put another way, all humanity dies worshipping the Father and the Son. The three-dimensional space is the dimension of death. Three is the symbol associated with the shape of the deity. The deity is the Luciferian egregore group of thinking entities. This Luciferian egregore who initiated the thought process is the light bringer. The thought process is energy, and energy is light. Light kills, therefore the number three, the shape of the deity, is symbolic of the god of death. The thought process is designed to establish a reality through a chain of subliminals that will lead to the ultimate goal within the Luciferian agenda. The word deity suggests financial problems in the world, which in turn cause unemployment and misery. This ultimately leads to the judgment day of the Lord and his day of vengeance, and the ultimate cleansing of the earth celebrated at the marriage supper of the Lamb. Deity equals die, tie equals diet, with the accompanying subliminal that what we eat will bring death. Death equals deet, or debt equals financial ruin. Financial ruin equals fiancé urine equals fiancé Orion equals golden shower sex ritual equals marriage supper. The pages that follow will demonstrate how completely obsessed the Luciferian thought process is with the concept of Allah, the law, and the fabricated judgment of LA the city, and the sister cities of Las Vegas, Sin City, San Francisco, Phoenix, and San Diego. The cities that relate to the foundation rock and the well of souls, located under the Dome of the Rock in Jerusalem, and shown and described on page 18 and beyond on this site. The cities that relate symbolically to the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah, as well as a few other ancient cities located on the Dead Sea, devastated by fire and brimstone, and destroyed by the judgment of God. All this is simply ancient subliminal manipulation of what is about to happen to many parts of the world, and ultimately, to the 11 Western states, centered at the head table of California. Keep in mind that this is all hypnosis, and what appears to be ancient in the 3D scope of things, is simply occurring right now, and meant to establish a reality so as to cause all to experience the great and terrible day of the Lord's vengeance. Time is not a real and true concept. Therefore, the events recorded from ancient times are only subliminals shaping our illusory plan as we move through our 3D life experience.